In this way he could obtain a double grip upon his victim. At 2:30 that afternoon, his clerk announced a caller. "Man or woman?" "A man, sir," said the clerk. "I think he's from Mulberry's Bank." "Do you know him?" asked Steadlin. "No, sir, but he came yesterday when you were out, and asked if you'd received the bank's balance sheet." Mr. Steadlin took a cigar from a box on the table and lit it. "Show him in," he said, anticipating nothing more exciting than a dishonored check from one of his clients. The man who came in was obviously in a state of agitation. He closed the door behind him and stood nervously fingering his hat. "Sit down," said Steadlin. "Have a cigar, Mr. Curtis, sir," said the other huskily. "Thank you, sir. I don't smoke." "Well, what do you want?" asked Steadlin. "I want a few minutes' conversation with you, sir, of a private character." He glanced apprehensively at the glass partition which separated Mr. Steadlin's office from the little den in which his clerks worked. "Don't worry," said Steadlin humorously. "I can guarantee that screen is soundproof. What's your trouble?" He scented a temporary embarrassment, and a bank clerk temporarily embarrassed might make a very useful tool for future use. "I hardly know how to begin, Mr. Steadlin," said the man, seating himself on the edge of a chair, his face twitching nervously. "It's a terrible story, a terrible story." Steadlin had heard about these terrible stories before, and sometimes they meant no more than that the visitor was threatened with bailiffs and was anxious to keep the news from the ears of his employers. Sometimes the confession was more serious, money lost in gambling and a desperate 11th-hour attempt to make a good financial deficiency. "Go on," he said. "You won't shock me." The boast was a little premature, however. "It's not about myself, but about my brother, John Curtis, who'd been a cashier for 20 years, sir," said the man nervously. "I hadn't the slightest idea that he was in difficulties, but he was gambling on the stock exchange, and only today he has told me the news. I am in terrible distress about him, sir. I fear suicide. He is a nervous wreck." "What has he done?" asked Steadlin impatiently.